Finally, tonight, on a lighter note, we end with Jeffrey Brown's story of bluegrass players wedded to making music and to each other.
Dana, won't you blow? Dana, won't you blow? Dana, won't you blow your horn? Dana, won't you blow? Dana, won't you blow? Dana, won't you blow your horn?
It's not exactly dueling banjos when these two get together. They are husband and wife, Bela Fleck and Abigail Washburn, who've long enjoyed separate musical careers but are now recording and touring together. Their recently released debut album has already topped Billboard's bluegrass charts. We talked to them earlier this year at the Rocky Grass Festival in Lyons, Colorado.
I think we knew it was going to work up front.
But we did.
Because Abby's grandmother had invited us to play at her church, and that was the first time we ever did a concert together. And it fell together so easily, and people liked it as much as anything we had ever done separately.
The 56-year-old Fleck, a 15-time Grammy winner, is recognized as one of the virtuoso banjo players of the era. He's led the genre-bending ensemble Bela Fleck and the Flecktones. But he's also known for his experiments with jazz, rock and roll, and classical music. 3 years ago, he wrote his first standalone concerto for banjo. Seven-year-old Abigail Washburn is known for more traditional old-time banjo music, playing solo, and also as a part of the all-female bluegrass band called Uncle Earl. As a couple, they finish each other's sentences. But their different styles of playing, well, that can bring problems.
We have different limitations and different challenges in playing together. And I think Abby has technical challenges that get posed because I ask her to do things she hasn't done before.
Like what?
Oh, all kinds of things. I mean, like, just to play a chromatic scale is like hard for me. The world I come from is these tunes that just are trance-like and they repeat over and over again, almost like Irish or Scottish traditional music, Appalachian American music.
We play very different styles. Abby's going to play for you a little bit of what's called the clawhammer style. Notice that she is not wearing any picks on her right hand. Our right hands are really big different.
Really different.
I got three finger picks. Abby's got some fingers and stuff.
And I strike down and he pulls up.
Okay. And Bela, you do something different. Three fingers.
So by rotating these three fingers, all the sound comes out with very little effort. So even if I'm just doing the right hand, no finger has to go much faster than that, but it sounds like this. Start to add the other hand. We're playing it almost like a guitar with a flat pick, but by going up and down with the forefinger.
So that turns the banjo into more of a solo instrument?
Turns it more into an actual musical instrument.
What?
Uh-oh.
I tried to play the banjo as if it were a musical instrument.
What is she playing?
I'm just joking because people always act like the banjo isn't a real instrument, you know. When I started playing, people weren't really playing the scales on the banjo in a way that understood the whole neck, like a good jazz guitar player would, basically. Or a good violinist would. So that was a great opportunity for me. I could figure out a little Bach. Or some Charlie Parker stuff.
You like those?
I'm curious, and I love all these different kinds of music. And the more I play different kinds of music, the more I see the connection between them all.
The two of them, in fact, have explored connections with banjo music all around the globe. Washburn, who studied Chinese in college and is fluent in Mandarin, has toured China and adapted its folk music into banjo tunes.
We
We can only communicate with music.
Yeah, music, yeah.
Fleck, meanwhile, has explored the roots of banjo music, which can be traced back to the slave trade in Africa.
There's an instrument here that may be the original banjo.
Wherever they go, they say, there's enthusiasm for their instrument.
What do you think accounts for the enduring love of this music?
It feels something like something true and honest to people, you know. It's not a smoothed over, overproduced kind of a situation like most of the music we hear on the radio in almost every idiom.
There's a sense of connection to our country and who we are as a nation when you hear this music, and a sense of connection to history and what came before. It's called roots music because I think it makes us feel rooted, like a tree. If we're the leaves, this music is the roots, and it makes us feel satisfied and nourished and strong.
The two plan to continue touring together for the foreseeable future, partly because they're now a trio. Their 21-month-old Juno accompanies them on the road.
I have a lot of friends who've had kids and traveled as musicians and were gone for the whole childhood. And often, sometimes the marriage didn't work out too. And I don't want to make that mistake with this opportunity.
Just an obvious fit. And to be able to sit up there on stage in front of an incredible audience and look over to the side and see our little boy sitting there playing, it feels like a dream come true that I never even imagined.
No sign yet if Juno will take up the family banjo business. I'm Jeffrey Brown for the NewsHour from Lyons, Colorado.